All right, check this out. If you're feeling down, you got a little bit of winter blues, eat some bacon. Man, I just had some bacon and my motivation and energy level is just like through the roof right now. All right, so a buddy of mine came over and looked at my new box, right? And he says, well, can I start my car with it? And I was like, well, yeah, maybe, but not through these DC, you know, power taps here. And I had these from my other build, right? And I'm thinking, well, where can I put these dogs? I maybe put them like right here, and then put some four gauge, you know, double four gauge to both batteries on the back there, you know, run the wires in there. What do you think? Think that's a good idea? I kind of like it. You know, you can also use it for other stuff too, you know, for higher current. I also want to say thanks to John on Facebook. This morning I posted a couple of pictures, you know, kind of showing what I wanted to do with this box. And he said, oh yeah, man, you need to do that. Here, I'm just taking you through some of the knickknacks and paddywhacks I have on this thing. It's a dual position double throw switch, controls the LED lights. Here's my cigarette lighter. Gotta have that, right? You can also use that as a 12-volt power socket, too. All right, check this out. Here's a voltage check using my Fluke True RMS 117 digital voltmeter. Got good volts on there. Before we take a peek inside the box, there's my battery tender junior connected to the box via the SAE 2-pin. Plugs right there in the front. Ease of access. All right, for this new mod I did to this box, you know, the red and black power access there, what I ended up doing was using 6-gauge wire on the battery terminals and parallel them down at the terminal post. And I'll get in here with my Big Larry flash'em light and show you exactly what the heck I'm talking about here. So I got two batteries, I got two lines of 6-gauge crimped together with a lug, then heat shrunk over and then connected to the post there on both the positive and negative. So each wire, according to American wire gauge, it's the 6-gauge is good for 50 amps each, so I can pull 50 amps off of each battery for a total of 100 amps. For the connections there, in between the wires, I used a star locking washer, and it grips down really, really good and tight. Take another little peek there. There's the inverter right there, Ames. 300 watt pure sine wave in the EP Ever tracer down there on the bottom. Also relocated some of the wires for ease of access and maintenance. All right, let's take a look on the back side here real quick. Then I'm going to throw you some still photos. That's the solar input right there. All right, guys, hey, thanks for watching and check this out.